What a song. The Traitors has proved you can't really trust anyone. It's been an epic season, and this Sunday night is the grand finale. So who will win the prize pool of solid silver? Will it be a traitor or will it be a faithful? Here to give us all the insight is the host of 10's most mysterious show, Rodger Corser. Welcome back.
Good morning.
Good morning. You're looking sharp, ready for the finale.
I try, you know, put a bit of effort in.
So close to the end.
Yes.
So close. Down to two faithfuls and two traitors.
Yep.
What can we expect from the finale?
Well, look, I don't think I'm overstating it in saying that our finale is probably the best finale of any reality show ever in the history of television. I don't think I'm overstating that at all. It's so shocking. It's so dramatic that it set my hair grey overnight, as you can see from the show there. Obviously, the Just for Men sponsorship has run out. Well, we'll be working on that.
No, it's a great, a bit more pepper anyway.
Look, it comes down to the wire, and yeah, you sort of don't believe what lengths people will go to get the money, but
they do it. That's the thing. Have you been surprised by the ruthlessness of the traitors in particular?
I think initially, yeah. I mean, I was sort of quoted as saying I couldn't actually be a contestant in this show because it's very easy to take a character on, but when you've got to sort of back up your own personality in public afterwards, I think I'd find that kind of difficult. But as they went along, they got more and more comfortable with bald-faced lying.
Oh, absolutely. So, and crocodile tears.
So many crocodile tears.
Alex's, you know, tears when the people she banished went.
She's very good.
She deserves a Logie.
Well, you know, we all would. We all would like a Logie, especially after 20 years. Anyway, I digress.
Is that hard to do, cry like that?
Yeah, I thought it was. I used to have little tricks to do it on camera. I would, you know, pull nostril hairs very slowly before I went on, you know, to make your eyes water and slowly.
Oh, right.
Yep. watch, you know, sad puppy dog videos on YouTube before I went on set. But she could just do it at the drop of a hat. She's very, very good. And, you know, there may or may not be a few more crocodile tears to come. But they seem to be falling for it.
That's brilliant.
They do.
Mm.
What's been really fascinating about the show as well is the contestants have had to compete in challenges to earn their prize money. So how much money have they won so far?
I think going into tonight, we're just over the $210,000 mark. So they've got a little bit of to make up. But we do finish with a grand challenge there. May or may not be helicopters.
Wow.
Below the budget in the last episode, yes. But we give them a chance to get up to the 250 in an all or nothing challenge. So they don't all work together. They get no more, but if they do, they get 40 grand.
So Kent and I wanted to be... we wanted to feel the pressure of a challenge. Mm-hmm. And you're going to challenge us.
Yeah,
today,
welcome to the Channel 10 Christmas party. there's a beer keg and a ping pong ball here somewhere.
Beer pong.
So what we're going to do, we're going to have a little challenge. I'm going to ask you some questions about the show while you are building a red cup tower.
Right,
like,
okay.
Like your college film type of thing. You know, you can do it quickly or what. And now if you get an answer correct, you get to knock down the other person's tower.
Oh!
You see. And so you...
Wherever they're up to.
Yeah, wherever they're up to. Okay. And you've got to start again.
Okay. Right, got it.
Okay? I might need to pull out the glasses here because I'm going a little bit
blind. Are they a crop, you're going full Clooney on us, Roger.
There we go.
All right.
Very handsome.
That's right. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Oh, here you, so start building.
Start building. All right. Ange.
Yes.
First question. Who was the first faithful to be murdered?
Murdered?
Yes. Come on, news is coming.
Oh, jeez.
Three.
Millie.
Correct.
Oh! That's right, because it was a Millie.
Oh. The best part. Oh. We didn't think this through because now someone's got to pick the cups up.
Yeah. That's all right, keep going.
Okay, keep going, okay. Sarah, where do the traitors meet every night to discuss the murder? And it's not a spa, but that's the other show I want to vote.
That's in Traitor Towers.
Correct. You get to.
Oh, this feels too good.
That was a touch aggressive, wasn't
it? It's been a long week, right. Roger. All right.
Ange, what is the name of the contestant who is a chess champion?
Jack.
Correct. I'm going to stand back.
She is a super fan. She's going to beat me.
This is actually very sad. Oh, I missed
it. It is good. It feels good, right?
There we go.
obviously part of their renegotiation for next year. Sarah, which traitor did Faithful Chloe, who is a clairvoyant, guess correctly? Traitors. Chloe guessed two traitors.
She did guess two, and she guessed... Who did she get? Not MK, because MK was out pretty early.
I think she's run out of time, Rodger.
Right, Ange, who won the first shield?
The first shield was won by Nigel.
Oh, God, she's good at this game. And Sarah, what was the first challenge of the series? Where was it?
In a graveyard.
And that's all the time that I have.
Everyone's a winner. I think
Cup Towers was the winner here. And please tune in Sunday night at 7:30.
We're really excited for the finale. It is going to be a cracker grand finale this Sunday night, 7:30 p.m. on 10 and 10 Play on Demand. Rodger Corser, thanks for coming in.
Thank you. Thanks,
see
ladies.
See you soon.
Fun.
Well, see, it feels too good.
Many cups.
Quote of the day already. It's not even 9 o'clock.